But when he got back and that spirit left him, we find him in the next chapter under a juniper tree saying, Lord, there's none left but me. Lord, I'm the only one living right. I'm here to tell you the angel come to him, said, son of man, eat the fruit, amen, the meat. Amen, this God sustained you for these 40 days. Amen, God, you go over here and you wait for a word from the Lord. And he was in a cave. It wasn't a fire, it wasn't a wind, but it was a still small voice that spoke to Elijah. He said, don't you, amen, sit here. You get up and you go anoint Elijah to be prophet after your stead. You go anoint Jehu, amen, God, to be the king. Get up, I'm here to tell you when one falls, God raise up another. I thank God for the anointing that causes us to outrun the chariot sometimes. And when I do get down, he'll send me some food to pick me up and carry me the rest of the way. He's still God. Amen. Whether you're on the mountain, whether you're in the valley, he's Almighty God, and he will bless his people. Yeah. Woo! Because of his grace. Titus 2 and 11, for the grace of God that bringeth salvation has appeared unto all men. Appear, become visibly known.
Yes.
Whether it's through a Sunday school lesson, whether it's through a gospel preaching, whether it's through some gospel singing, whether it's a missionary on the forefront that risking their lives and spreading the love, spreading Christ and him crucified. That grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to all men. Every man, every woman, every boy, every girl, amen to God, has had a chance to get saved. And what you do with that chance is up to you. What you do with that presentation is up to you. Some people present it a little better than others. Some people preach a little better than others. And I consider myself the least of the preachers. But all I can do is do my best. I want to present Christ in such a way you can't help but want to want him. You can't help to want to taste and see that he is good. You can't help to want to say, hey, I want that grace in my life. I'm tired of living the way I'm living. I'm tired of living on the bottom, living in the flesh. I want that quickening power to touch my soul. And God's grace is sufficient to touch you tonight.
Yes.
Woo! Titus 3 and 5, not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to his mercy, he saved us. Thank God for the mercy of God. Where would we be without mercy? We're all vessels of mercy. Every time you see someone saved, you see mercy walking. Amen. When they're on the death row, they bring them out and they're walking down to get their last meal. They say, dead man walking. He's going to get his last meal that he desired, whether it's lobster, Sister Vogan, amen to God, or whether it's prime rib, whatever his favorite meal is. It might even be dressed in red, I don't know, and whatever your favorite color is. I learned some things this past Valentine's senior banquet. Amen to God, but I'm here to tell you, brother and sister, amen, I'm not a dead man walking. When you're in sin, you're a dead man walking. You may be eating your last meal in sin. Amen to God, you may be living your last day upon the earth. But if you've been quickened by the power of God and through the grace of Jesus Christ, amen to God, you are living forever. And you are alive. You have life in you. And the light of the gospel's touched your life. And when they see you, it's not dead man walking. It's Holy Ghost walking. Amen to God. It's living in the grace of God. It's not my life, but it's his life. Paul said, amen to God. I live, but yet not I, but Christ liveth in me. And the life that I live in this flesh, I live by the faith of the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. Thank God I'm living tonight. If you hadn't been saved, you don't know what it is to live. People say, well, I'm living it up if I go to the Mardi Gras. I'm living it up if I go see, amen, my favorite people perform in the concert. I'm going to tell you, God's not in the concert business no more, but I'm still living it up. I don't go, amen, to the Mardi Gras. I've never been there, but I'm still living in Christ. And I'd rather have the Holy Ghost, amen, touching my soul than I would, amen, to have all the beads of the world thrown at me.
Yeah.
Woo! Oh. Amen. People thought they was living it up because they went to Woodstock. Some of you old stonies know what I'm talking about. You thought you had life. But I'm here to tell you that wasn't nothing but Tommy Rot. But Jesus come to give us life. And life more abundantly. Freely given. God, can I come to church enough? Can I merit enough of your favor? Can I fast 40 days and have your favor?
Jesus.
I'm here to tell you, Israel fasted. God said, is this the fast that I chosen? They tried to merit God's favor, break his laws. And he said, yet you come to my house. You come to my house, you're doing wickedness, yet you come to my house and say, you fast, you kept this ceremony, you kept this ceremony, you've done this, you've done that. He said, all I see is, amen to God, unclean hands and unclean hearts. All I see is abomination and desolation in my temple. Amen. He said, bring me, even John the Baptist said, bring me fruit met for repentance. Don't tell me you're the children of Abraham. Well, my daddy preached there. My mama did that. I'm here to tell you, everyone's got to come the same way. That's at the foot of the cross. Amen. Is a fruit not for repentance. He said, I'll make these stones the children of Abraham. But if you've got the goods, people, I know you've got the goods, because the fruit will bear, your tree will be right, your tree will be holy, your tree will be clean, because something took place in your heart. The grace of God has been freely given to your soul.
Yeah.
Woo! Thank Jesus. Thanks belong to God. Amen. Freely given, Psalms 84 and 10, for a day in the courts is better than 1,000. I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of God than I would to dwell in the tents of the wicked. I'd rather have one day in God's court than I would have 1,000 in the president's White House. You got all these groupies that just fall all over their rock and roll stars and their rap stars and their bling and their gold teeth and their pants on the ground. Some of you know where I'm going right there. Amen to God. But I'd rather have one day in the court of the Lord, one day in the presence of Jehovah, than to have 1,000 in the tents of the wicked. I'd rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God. I'd rather be a nobody that people don't even recognize and know that I've been praying for somebody, know that I've opened up the door for somebody, than I would, amen to God, to be the top advisor to the president's secret council. Amen to God, the top executive to all the countries. Amen to Bill Gates. I mean to tell you, I'd rather be a little doorkeeper. I'd rather be a little tent dweller in the house of God than I would have dwelt in the tent, amen, the tents of the wicked. For the Lord God is the sun and the shield. The Lord will give grace and glory. No good thing will he withhold to them that walk uprightly. O Lord of hosts, blessed is the man that trusteth in thee. I'm glad to know he told me no good thing will he withhold from me. What do you need from heaven tonight? Trust God for it again. What do you need from heaven tonight? Lay hold to his promises. It's his good pleasure to give us the kingdom. It's his good pleasure to pour heaven upon the church. It's his good pleasure to anoint us again. It's his good pleasure to heal your body. It's his good pleasure to bless the church. Amen to God. But we don't think he can do it no more. Well, I don't know about you, but God's grace has not changed. His heaven's still open for those who walk upright, those who have been washed and redeemed and sanctified through the blood of the Lamb. We got access to heaven, and we can pray again and trust God again. Can someone lay hold, say, Lord, I need a blessing tonight. I need a touch of God tonight. He said he would not withhold it from you, but he would pour it out upon you and bless you and help you. Can we lay hold to the grace of God again? Yeah.